कहते हैं कि इंसान की पहचान उसके नाम से नहीं, उसके काम से होती है। इसी सोच के साथ मारवाड़ी युवा मंच गुवाहाटी ग्रेटर आया एक अनोखे टॉक शो के साथ, एक अनोखे इंसान के साथ। मैं रोहन केडिया, मारवाड़ी युवा मंच का एग्जीक्यूटिव मेंबर और एक मोटिवेशनल स्पीकर होने के नाते आप सभी को नवरात्रि की हार्दिक शुभकामनाएं देता हूँ। मिलवाऊंगा आज आपको एक ऐसे शख्सियत से जिन्होंने ये प्रूफ कर दिया कि हर एक औरत में एक दुर्गा है। सी इज अ डेप्यूटी डायरेक्टर ऑफ गवर्नमेंट ऑफ आसाम एंड OSD ऑफ नेशनल हेल्थ मिशन गुवाहाटी, मिस पोमी बरुआ।
यस,
हेलो मिस बरुआ, ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ मारवाड़ी युवा मंच आई वेलकम यू टू आवर शो।
थैंक यू
एंड आई विश यू वेरी हैप्पी नवरात्रि।
थैंक यू वेरी मच।
मैम हाउ आर यू?
आई एम गुड, थैंक यू रोहन।
मैम माय फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज हाउ डू यू बिलीव दैट यू आर इन अ पर्सन, हाउ डू, व्हाट आर योर स्ट्रेंथ्स?
First of all, happy Navratri to all the viewers. And well, he has asked an interesting question. That is, what is my strength? Right?
Yes, ma'am.
I feel my greatest strength has been not to give up in midst of even different kinds of hardships and struggles that have come to my life, and patience. Yes, and I don't easily lose my temper. That is what I have been told. So yes,
ma'am, you served as a lecturer in the Durham College, Tejpur. Mm,
yes.
What made you to join the ACS?
No, actually, I did my graduation and master's in Delhi University. So while studying there, I always thought of joining the civil services. So since I did not, while studying in Delhi, during the last year of my post-graduation, my grandfather died. So I had to come back to Assam. Somehow I couldn't sit for my UPSC exams. And then I immediately sat for this interview for a lecturer in Durham College. So I was enjoying my stint there because I liked teaching students and liked being in their company. But then, of course, being a part of the administrative structure and civil services has always, attracted me. So when the opportunity came to write the exams, I took the exams. I took the exams and I passed with very flying colors, and that's how. And this actually, the idea, there was always a pull to join the civil services because this is one area where you can, when you have a direct interface with the people, you can actually work for your land and for your people. You have a direct interface with people in various capacities.
Yes.
And you have a lot of exposure in this area. So this is the reason that motivated me to serve my people and serve my land.
Really, it's a totally uncommon profession which usually it needs lots of courage to join that profession. As a female leader, what has been the most significant barrier in your life?
No, I haven't faced barriers as such, but then of course you have a lot of hiccups that keep happening when you are a woman. But basically the thing is that, say for example you are posted in an area far from home, and then when you have children, then that thing is always in your mind, no? That I'm going away from my kids. You know, being a mother and a wife, and generally what happens, that kind of thing is always there. So you should, I think, but that I don't take it as a barrier, because if you build up your own support system, then there is always a way to overcome all those issues. And otherwise, I don't think so that, there's any, I myself haven't faced any discrimination or something like that, that because I'm a woman, I have been given less work to do or something like that. No, I feel that it depends on individual to individual, how you actually, process
and...
it, yes, in your mind, and how you take steps to cross those barriers.
Yes.
So once you start crossing the initial things that come up, by virtue of being a woman. So then after that, I think, once you have made your stand clear, once you have established yourself as a person who keeps work, who gives importance to work and, doesn't look back, then I think there is no discrimination as such. So I haven't faced like that.
In my introduction, I have mentioned that in every female, there is a Durga. And you have really proved that.
I don't know about that. I've always felt that in every individual, whether it's a man or a woman, there is a divine in every individual, in every soul, you know, even anything that has a soul has a divine in it. So that is like that. And of course, a woman's role particularly becomes important because a woman has to take up various roles in her life, you know.
Yes, ma'am.
She has to play the important role of being in the house, homemaker, pura family ko
dekh ke
karna hai, jod ke rakhna hai family ko, being a wife, being a mother, and so many other things coming up. So when we come out to work, Rohan, I leave my kids behind at home. I leave my husband. Sometime back he called and he was like, you know, I don't have time to take his calls because series of meetings one after the other. Or when my daughter calls me, then mama, there's something important. So then I tell her, wait, there's something important that I'm doing, I'll call you back. So for a woman, we have to handle a lot of situations, and at the same time we have to be extremely strong. We are supposed to be very strong also. So like that, I think certain attributes in a woman, such as a generous and kind heart, feelings of empathy towards others, and you know, the overall strength that a woman exudes. Yes, ab milke I feel, yes, of course, there is a reflection of.
Ma'am, I strongly believe that the best manager in the world, that is a female. She manages every department in terms of her family, in terms of her profession, in terms of her extracurricular activities, social activities sphere. I myself believe that she is the best manager without having the degree of management.
Yeah, that is true. That is true. And that is not only about us. You know, when you look back and you see your grandmothers, your mother.
Yes, ma'am.
Everyone, no, through generations, women have been, handling every situation very well, home and everything. So, yes, I feel that women, without having a professional degree of being a manager, she is a very good
manager. She is a very good manager.
Yes, your kids fall ill, it is on you to rush
yes,
them.
Yes,
your kids' homework, their school projects, se leke, everything, the tantrums
everything.
And all, everything that. Women has to juggle a lot of activities in her life. Yes.
Ma'am, as a situation that was very much alarming during the time of lockdown, during the time of COVID, you were the person who were the fourth fight in the Assam's during the Assam fight against COVID-19. Ma'am, जब लोगों को डर लग रहा था घर से बाहर निकलते हुए कि आपको कभी डर नहीं लगा कि you were in the field. Working at the field,
yes.
आपको डर कभी नहीं लगा?
नहीं, actually see that उसका credit I would give to my seniors, जैसे you know our honourable chief minister sir को देखिए, our honourable minister sir, our honourable minister sir has been such a guiding force, you know, he has gone to the field, done so many things, you know, my principal secretary Samir Sinha sir or anybody, Lakshmanan sir, commissioner sir and all, and the various other leaders, they have all gone, माने field में जाके वो लोग कब से कर रहे हैं. So when I was called to join COVID duty, you know, तो मैंने पहले सोचा था कि मेरे घर में बहुत छोटा बच्चा है तो कैसे होगा, but my husband supported me and I thought नहीं, जब when duty calls तब तो करना ही है. So I came out and no, I didn't feel scared at all because the first orientation program which we had, वहाँ पे ऑनरेबल मिनिस्टर सर एंड इवन प्रिंसिपल सेक्रेटरी समीर सिन्हा सर, इतने अच्छे से उन लोगों ने बताया कि कैसे क्या करना है. एंड देन यू नो द कॉल ऑफ ड्यूटी आई थिंक सुपरसीड्स एवरीथिंग एल्स. इफ़ यू हैव दैट सेंस ऑफ ड्यूटी इन यू, देन आई थिंक फियर इज समथिंग वेरी सेकेंडरी. एंड इफ आई डोंट डू then I would not be able to sleep with an easy conscience at night, no?
Yes, ma'am.
और बाकी there are so many doctors, nurses, health workers, cleaners. सब तो बाहर आके
working, day and
working.
Night.
Yes, so this is the least you can do, you know.
Like you can that. Say duty comes first.
Yes, obviously.
As a state nodal officer of the 104 helpline, you were busy in collecting data of every patients, and you were busy in collecting data of in every sectors. You were busy in that. As a situation that was getting very much worsened, your work pressure increased simultaneously.
Yes.
You even changed the you changed the whole. The data collecting team, you totally changed it. You galvanized your whole team. How did you do it?
No, during there was always the 104 setup was always there, which has been playing giving yeoman's service to the state, you know, for health related calls and calls, etc. So when this COVID situation came up and we had to collect information, the first information, Tablighi Jamaat and all that. Then our Honorable Minister Sir had called me and then he said that being the nodal officer, you know, you have to ensure that we get the information that keeps coming and share it with us and all. So I used to sit in the 104 office on a regular basis, every day from morning to evening. We collected the information. The 10 team that we have, Piramal Swasth team is running 104 Sarthi. So we have a very dynamic and a very good team. So they collected information. Our agents, paramedics who take the calls, they collected the information. We had a very, we did the analysis very well. All the information was collected. We had the database and the information was, you know, we shared it with the various, in the field, the police, the district administration, to all the different strata of people, then who finally helped in using this information, going out to the people and finding out that, okay, we got a call about this person that he is a COVID positive patient or he has come from outside and needs investigation. So that information was passed to the districts. And then the different various sections of the entire wheel, you know, started working.
The algorithm made department. Was totally very fast.
Yeah, very fast. The health department, the police, the civil administration, everybody, you know, galvanized together. And that is how it was done. So we collected the information, we gave it, and then it was taken forward in a very efficient manner.
It was totally a very difficult task which was done at that moment. And I totally appreciate you for the whole work that was done that moment.
Thank you.
Ma'am, you are appreciated by the citizens of the state for the immediate actions which you have taken during that time of COVID. And one amongst the best was that the immediate informations, the immediate messages which you are giving to the citizens, either it may be significant message or any call, or it may be insignificant, but you attended personally to every calls and every messages.
Yes.
Really, I don't think that it was a very easy task for you, because at that time 9,000 calls were received and almost 3,000 to 4,000 outgoing calls were made. Ma'am, how this algorithm was made that you were totally engaged, you made yourself personally to contact with them?
Yeah, actually see, we have this setup in 104 by which, like I told you, you know, that various officials, personnels from various areas who all joined help. It was basically a teamwork.
Yes.
But whenever I used to get a distress message on my phone, because that time everyone started calling that my phones had become mini call centers themselves. So whenever I used to get phone calls in my personal numbers, I opened a Twitter account also that time, in Twitter and Facebook, or say somebody referred somebody to someone. That time I made it a point to, you know, personally intervene and help as many as possible, because I would always think that what if I was in that person's place, you know. So this is the least you can do, or aisa nahi ki, you know, something unthinkable I'm doing. So because the setup was already there, everybody is very helpful. Say if there are a lot of officers who jumped into
the moment you
then, and so you could always rely on someone or the other. And the best part was the dissemination of information was available to us and we could disseminate to the people, they could get the necessary help. And then you could also, actually the thing is when somebody calls you with, say, his set of problems, I need help, say in transportation, or you know, coming back from say Coimbatore to here, so getting in touch with the police, the health department, the transport department, everything like
the total, the different persons who were
very seamless. How it helped. And then on my personal account, yes, I have helped a lot of people. There were a lot of good Samaritans in Guwahati who have come forward to help a lot of people. So these are people who have, you know, who have, and then there are these section of people who needed help. So you just had to connect the people who wanted to help with the people who wanted
to help and who want help.
answer.
You totally connected.
So it is very easy that way. So people, there are a lot of people in Guwahati who have actually helped in their personal capacity.
Even I have heard that around 150 people you have engaged from work from home. You have engaged.
Yes. So we had taken volunteers that time at the very early stage. And these volunteers who came and who joined, work from home, and with no remuneration, nothing. They really helped. So yes. So this is actually, I feel, that it will be very wrong to say that these are things that I have done. This has happened because there were a lot of people who were behind my back, who were actually giving the support. So because of the support base I had. I mean, I could actually reach out to a lot of people. I used to get calls at 3 a.m. in the morning, 7 a.m. in the morning. I never felt that time. I think even divine, God, somehow He gives you this amazing energy during that time. Even the physical energy, it's a very taxing thing, taking phone calls the entire day, listening and doing all that. So it becomes very tiring also, and working very odd hours, morning say. Mm-hmm. Sometimes we would give like 17 hours, 16 hours, 12 hours. So it had become difficult also at one point, but somehow something kept you going. And I think, yeah, when you hear a distress call of a pregnant woman saying that, ma'am, we are stuck somewhere, we need help, even if that call comes at very odd hours also, how can you not help?
Yeah,
you would definitely, right, if when you hear about students stuck somewhere and who want to somehow manage transportation and come back.
We can't have a peaceful sleep at that moment.
And then when you have migrant workers who want to come back and then they do not have the money, and then they are at a loss. So what do you do? So whatever little I could do, with the help and support I received from a lot of wonderful people. So that is how it was done. And of course, the government setup was always there. Whenever there was anything, I could take up to my seniors. And they've been extremely, helpful and giving me the right insights and guiding that this is the way it's done. So I'm glad to the setup and of course to my seniors for having given me the opportunity, for having put me in a place where I could actually serve people. Because I think that is most important.
Most important. The teamwork is very much important.
And moreover, if I hadn't been picked up, maybe if I would have had to stay at home, working from home, or maybe, because that time I belonged to a different department. So then, of course, my scope of helping people would have been limited. So I'm grateful to God and for others who gave me the opportunity to actually, come and join this particular position where I could help others.
I'm right now remembering the one of the line my grandmother used to say me, that when we start doing any noble work or any noble thing which we think, when we think of doing, there is a divine spirituality which helps us in doing that work.
Course,
and I'm sure that you are saying that there was some divine spirituality, guiding you.
That's there. That kind of support, when you go home late, you come in the morning, and that was the phase when you were really scared.
Really
abhi toh people have got used to COVID. Abhi toh we are learning to live with COVID. Us waqt mein, there was complete lockdown. Itne kam log bahar the. When you would go out at night home, it was, the streets were deserted.
Totally
deserted. And then you have your kids who are at home. They have nothing else to do. School nahi hai and ye wo. So they,
zindagi ruk se gayi thi.
Yeah.
It was totally
and
like
then,
that.
So I feel that there is a support system somewhere, that He looks after everything and ensures that you can carry on your duties if you really want to from your heart.
Ma'am, you are looking after the plasma drive in the state.
I had been given the opportunity and the responsibility for, handling the plasma thing. Of course, the entire overall thing is going on under the direct supervision of my seniors, Lakshman and Sir, and all that. And so that time plasma donation had become very important, and since COVID 19 is a very new disease, and the coronavirus, this thing is so novel and so many things we haven't known. So that time, when plasma had become very important, plasma donation, so we had started the drive, with the blessings of administration and honorable minister sir, he took it personally, you know, so we started that, and we got plasmapheresis machines installed in Guwahati Medical College, in AMCH in Dibrugarh, then in Tejpur Medical College and Jorhat Medical College, and also Silchar Medical College. So yes, so that way plasma became a complete different kind of a campaign, and it really feels good now. So many people have been given convalescent plasma therapy, and again, but this again is a massive teamwork, you know. You get support from various areas. There were a lot of support from various people, from various departments, like across the state. So that is how it is.
Ma'am, right, some days before Sneha Sparsh program, which is started by the government of Assam, you are being a part of that. Ma'am, what is the program about?
See, Sneha Sparsh is actually, you know, it is a program where we give a financial support to children below 12 years of age for various diseases, you know, which are like extremely expensive. See, bone marrow transplant, cochlear implant, cancer, kidney, and other issues. So this is basically for children who are 12 years below, across various sections. So what we did was recently, that is on the 10th of October, we had a screening camp. We organized a screening camp with support from GMCH, Narayana Hridayalaya, where we had we could register 185 children who came from various districts in Assam.
185 children
who came for various diseases.
And they were totally from the Assam sector.
Yeah, all from Assam.
Various rural areas.
Yes, rural areas, also rural areas. And now we are going to have this every month.
Okay.
10th of every month, we will do this massive screening for children, you know, for various diseases. Like that day, in the Sneha Sparsh function that was held in the GMCH auditorium, our honorable minister sir had very clearly laid out the guidelines, and he had beautifully elucidated. So now we will be encompassing children who are below 12 years of age from different sections, you know, because these are very, very expensive treatments. So this is a very noble scheme. Where we will be actually touching the lives of these little children, you know, who have this huge future, long future ahead of them. So
yes,
helping them out at that stage, this will bring relief and succor to so many families across the state.
The government of Assam is totally doing a very noble job looking behind this. The unprivileged people, where the society doesn't look about it. Ma'am, one question I want to ask, that you were on the field working at the time of lockdown and the time of COVID. There was a huge work pressure over you, like totally frustrated, ye bhi karna hai, wo bhi karna hai, har ek kaam ko karna hai, but there was no work schedule, totally pre-planned. Ma'am, don't you ever thought that, ki nahi yaar, sab chhodo, chhod ke sab ghar chale jao?
No, I never thought that. I never ever thought that because, you know, I got a lot of support from my family. My husband and my children, no, most important, my children, they realized what I was doing. Initially, my son would ask, why would you be so late? Mama, you hardly have time. Because when I reached home, he was sleeping. When I left home, he would be sleeping. But then somehow, I would just manage to meet them for one and a half hours, 2 hours, jaise taise, before they would go off to sleep. So, but then they understood. Because there was this general thing, no, about COVID, TV mein hai, ye mein hai. So I explained to them. So un logon ko samajh mein aaya. And then because of the support also that I got from family, it is very important for a woman, you know, when you come out to work, you need a strong support system. It is important for that. And so maine kabhi nahi socha. And I was seeing all my colleagues, they're all working so hard day and night. Everyone, you know, district administration ho, NHM ke employees ho, all young girls, girls with small kids, elderly persons, doctors, nurses, you see the lab techs, how hard they are working, everyone, the police. And also when you see that so many people are working so hard, you look at the cleaners, no?
Yeah.
And then एंड देन यू नो दैट अर्ली डोज टाइम्स तो ऐसा भी था ना कि इफ यू आर एसोसिएटेड विद एनी काइंड ऑफ वर्क रिलेटेड टू कोविड योर बिल्डिंग के लोग या योर नेबर्स वुड एक्चुअली बी स्केयर्ड
कि उनको इग्नोर करने की कोशिश करते थे
वो एक स्टिग्मेटाइजेशन था ना इनिशियल स्टेज में सो वो सब को भी यू नो वो करके साइड करके सो मेनी पीपल वुड हु आर वर्किंग सीरियसली केम टू वर्क केम आउट टू वर्क सो वो नहीं था सो फॉर वन मोमेंट ऑल्सो आई नेवर थॉट कि सोचा कि यू नो ये क्या हो रहा है बिकॉज दैट टाइम यू रियलाइज दैट यू नो एवरी drop counts you know even the smallest iota of effort that is put in against this covid crisis is important so then in fact I would get mentally it was like very mentally exhausting at times physically also but then you I never had that kind of a negative attitude to this because I felt rather that you know I have been given a lifetime opportunity you know to be part of this exercise this mammoth exercise in saving people or helping people in any way I can to wo thought kabhi nahi aaya I can say that
sach mein madam right now I have totally feel to say that your words really I'm sure ki har ek females ko encouragement to zarur degi ki
totally because I feel that a woman you know is a repository of huge amount of power हर औरत में इतना स्ट्रेंथ है थिंग इज दैट यू डोंट मे बी यू डोंट रियलाइज हाउ स्ट्रांग यू आर
That may be main thing that people try to underestimate them. They are, I'm hearing that.
No, वो सब तो है ही ना. When a woman and a man come out to work, वो mentality क्या रहता है? I would rather लड़का को ले लेते हैं. He'll run around more. Yeah. वो रात तक रह पाएगा. वो सुबह जल्दी आएगा. उसका family liabilities नहीं है. You take a woman, उनका ये रहेगा ना वो कि मेरा बच्चा आज तबीयत खराब है कि tomorrow my daughter's exam. मुझे घर को संभालना है somebody is unwell I have to take care so generally that mentality is there you
there
know
is,
that
there is.
It is always better to take a man he'll you know he'll perform more
yeah, sure.
that thing is there but I feel that with that kind of a mindset also which is prevalent in society a woman there are so many women who have done extremely well you know you know they are doing so much when a ghar bhi acha se chal raha hai and then they are coming out and doing giving exemplary service in their own
field.
in their own field so I feel that a woman should not let all these kind of thoughts or orientations bog her down mane agar aapko kaam karna hai to you will manage it somehow I feel like that
I heard that I really believe sometimes one of my people I have met, one of the female, she said that I work my liabilities and everything. The family that family support was like ki tum kaam kar rahi ho, apne liability pe kaam karo. We are not responsible for it. And the people the she said, नहीं मैं तो ठीक हूँ मैं अपनी लाइबिलिटी पे ही काम कर रही हूँ आई डोंट वांट एनीवन्स मेरे जो भी काम का कंसीक्वेंसेस होगा आई विल बी बेयरिंग
इट
नाउ यू वर आल्सो व्हाट वर द जनरल प्रॉब्लम्स दैट यू फेस्ड इन द फील्ड
प्रॉब्लम्स बीन द जनरल दैट एवरीबॉडी वाज फेसिंग नो बिकॉज़ यू फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यू हैड टू डील विद द फियर That you never know when you would turn COVID positive.
Yes, ma'am.
So the initial stage, वो एक डर तो रहता ही है कि you might get COVID and then you had to, you know, और वो था ना even if you were sneezing for something else, you know, maybe dust allergy हुआ मैंने sneeze किया.
तो भी एक बार लगता था कि कहीं कुछ.
Maybe कुछ अटक गया गले में and I started coughing and then you keep thinking at the back of your mind.
कहीं कुछ हो गया हो.
And then you come home and उस वक्त मेरा सबसे ज़्यादा डर ये था कि I'll be infecting my son because my son wouldn't because kya hota hai ki people who are working na many medical workers and all they would quarantine themselves because they were directly in touch with patients although we were not directly working with patients but we were out in the field so when you come home I also thought that I will also quarantine myself maybe stay in a separate room mane ki bachchon ke sath definitely interactions hoga lekin not so close
distance
maintain karke which is very practical which many have done but in many households and in mine also the little one would always be with me cling to me pakad ke usko sona hai to wo dar mujhe bilkul tha us waqt कि कहीं यू नो आई ब्रिंग द इन्फेक्शन एंड पास इट ऑन टू हिम. तो ये सब था एंड देन दीज आर द बेसिकली इश्यूज एंड अदर थिंग्स. नो आई डोंट थिंक सो देयर वर एनी.
दिस वाज अ बेसिक फियर दैट कि आपको बस वो डर था कि कहीं आपके वजह से आपके.
अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट आई डिड नॉट फेस एनी hardship because I was like very self driven and I was extremely motivated at that time.
कि आपको field में जाना है, काम करना है,
काम करना है. I was very motivated. In fact, I would feel bad, you know, if I was doing too much of desk work only. So initial days में when I was given the opportunity to be at the airport, then Kiran Shri Grand May, we started that first screening center. So I was there also for some time. Initial stage mein we only set it up, and then with the guidance of Commissioner Secretary Anurag Goel sir, and then Horo Hojai mein also have worked. Then I was in the field, so that is the thing. Wo nahi tha ki hurdles aisa kuch nahi tha.
Hearing to you, madam, सच में मेरे को ऐसा लग रहा है कि totally I am very much motivated right now by meeting you really. Ma'am, identity comes from work, not by name. I think you believe it.
Yeah.
Ma'am, what do you want to say about this?
Yeah, definitely. You know, it is. How do you actually have a name? So and so. So and so ka naam kahan se aata hai? Naam to kaam se hi aata hai, na?
Kaam se.
So it is basically the work that you do. You know, defines you. And then the work cannot be that okay. You are sitting on the chair of a bureaucrat. Or you were sitting on the chair of you're very successful businessman or businesswoman. It is not like that. It is you can. I believe and I firmly believe in the dignity of labor. जो भी position you have been given in life, उसमें अगर आप अच्छा से काम करें ना, तो then you carve a name for yourself.
Sure.
Based on the work that you are doing.
Really.
Because I think you can shine in every field.
बस काम जरूर काम
को कितना. You can be a teacher. You can be an excellent teacher. Or you can be just a teacher.
You can be an. Total devotion. Yes, exactly.
You can be a farmer. You can be just a farmer. है कि नहीं.
Yeah, such man.
So वो होता है ना. Sometimes why do we run like cooks? This cook is definitely better than that cook. I mean, you shine, your you name shine. Comes. So I believe in the dignity of labor. Whatever work you are doing, one should do well. And depending on the work that you are giving, the efforts that you are putting in, obviously you get a name like that.
Yes, surely, ma'am. Ma'am, besides being into a civil service, besides being all the works of the COVID lockdown, you are also founder of the Awas Foundation.
Yeah.
What is the Awas Foundation? What
no, actually, Awas Foundation is an NGO that that's like more than 15 years old now, 10-15 years. So we were basically working for underprivileged children that time, and we had been given opportunity like 10 years back to work in the child labor project. You know, where we set up 4 schools. And we were teaching children who were basically came from the child labor background, who were, you know, selling eggs and potatoes in the marketplaces or working as cleaners or housemaids. So we would actually get those. We did a survey. We would teach them, and you know, once they were they reached a particular level, then we would mainstream them in the main schools and all. So we were doing this with the district administration, but however now we are trying to do other projects such as, you know, building awareness amongst women and children, cleanliness drives, hygiene and all that. But however, because of, you know, the schedule, my work, so I have not been able to give much thing. So my friends Rinku Khadria and Kasturi and all, there are a group of girls, Jini Chaudhary and all, Archana. So these are actually friends, and they have they've been there. You know, that is how they are pulling it, rather than me kind of.
Ma'am, is it an organization which was started by you totally with your friends?
Yeah, we had started it with friends long time back for social work. So we keep doing all this work that way. So now it's being basically run by my friends only, like that.
I can. Say that you are a very good social worker too.
Thank you.
Now today you are the person who is known by every citizen of the state.
I don't know.
Basically,
I really don't know.
Now you are also an inspiration to all the female society and basically really to the youth sector. Huh. How do you feel?
No, nothing like that. I've taken it in my stride. I mean, you do work and then people come to know you, and then I'm a very grounded person. Okay, tomorrow you don't deliver, then people stop knowing you, right? So whether they know or they don't know, that actually doesn't make any difference to me, whatever. But I feel good when you know, you've helped a lot of people, and then usme se koi ek do, when they sent a thank you message, then that is that motivates you to help somebody else. Yeah, it's like that. But otherwise, you know, people knowing me, it has kind of, because I am a little different kind of a person, so they know me, it is very nice. But then again, they know me because the virtue of my work. So if I work and if I deliver, then it is like that, you know.
No, totally, you can say that it is a continuous work, that the name which keeps the name alive.
Yes, it's like that.
Ma'am, coming to the end of the session, my last question is, what is the suggestion, what is the advice you you'd like to give to all the young females who are entering to a male dominated profession?
Well, I would say that you have to be very strong, you know, first of all. Strong in terms of you should feel that you should give your best, no matter what. You should give your best. There will be a lot of hurdles and struggles, but you should not feel scared or intimidated by the feeling that, you know, it's a man's world. Kaise karenge? You will find your way. Depends on each particular girl or woman to find and carve their own way. You should build a support system around you, which is very important, which will enable you to go forward. And then there will be a lot of criticism, lot of negative things also coming your way. You should not, I feel every girl shouldn't expect it to be a very rosy thing. I mean, it happens for men also. You expect something else happens. But jo bhi ho, mane aapko lage rehna hai, you know, you should go ahead, and you should, and I feel that personally a person should be motivated with whatever kind of profession you've taken, you know, you should have that amount of mental strength and motivation.
So that
and
we can face the profession.
Yeah, you should, so that you can really do well in whatever you have taken. There's no point in doing a job half-heartedly, you know, then you will be a very frustrated and sad soul. So if you are not happy with what you are doing, if you feel that, you know, this doesn't suit you, then it's a different thing. Then you should take a step back, think, and go for something which actually suits your temperament and suits your psyche, you know. Not everybody may like to do all kinds of work.
Sure.
So we are all different individuals. So I feel it is, first of all, you have to be, you have to think about, before taking the dive, you have to think what you want to do, and then you should actually chart your own course.
Yes,
so
ma'am.
And then jitna bhi wo date rehna hai, wo
date rehna hai, apne kaam karte rehna hai,
kaam karte rehna hai, and rest, everything will be, you will get, people will come to know you, people will respect you, you will get the respect you deserve once you
hurdles
start.
Shuruaat mein aati
hai. Hurdles aega, hurdles will keep coming, but then, you know, you should think of it as a race, na? You should keep going,
daute,
you should keep jumping, you will fall also.
Yeah, surely.
But it doesn't mean that if you fall, you should just, pack your bags and go off from the scene, no. Girna hai, chot lagega. You should get up and keep going. One should keep going, and for that, again, one should make oneself extremely motivated. That is most important. And then service. I mean, you should be honest to the work that you are doing. As long as you are honest to whatever work you are doing, I'm sure you will really shine. And most important is the, even if no one comes to know about you or whatever, you will have a very good, satisfying feeling inside you, and you'll be able to go off to sleep with a very clean and clear conscience. That is most important.
Well, ma'am, talking to you was really a very good experience for me also, and really right now I am too very much motivated by the words, by the things you have said me.
Thank you.
Sure all the people who are watching the video will really like and they will totally get the encouragement to do something better, more there in their life. I, on behalf of Marwari Yuvamanch Ghati Greater, and I being personally really thankful, I'm totally thankful to you that you have given your some precious time and shared your experience too.
Thank you very much, Rohan. Thanks a lot.
Thank you, ma'am.